Well, hello, our fellow friends, our fellow neighbors, and our fellow shining stars. Our next trolley stop is here, and our next trolley stop is now. That's right, Little Forrest is the conductor of the trolley. Welcome back to another all-new episode of PR from the Heart's Children's Book Spotlight Series. It is our Christmas special at the Children's Book Spotlight Series. Precisely, we have reached episode number 166. That is the 166th trolley stop here at the Children's Book Spotlight Series and PR from the Heart. My name is John Masalonis, the manager here at PR from the Heart. And of course, as always with me, wherever I travel, is Little Forrest, the newest member of the PR from the Heart family. We hope that first off, that you have enjoyed your holiday season, that your Christmas is going absolutely wonderful, depending upon when you are watching episode number 166 of the Children's Book Spotlight Series. Christmas may already be in the rearview mirror, but we are still feeling very Christmassy nonetheless here at PR from the Heart and the Children's Book Spotlight Series. To all of our friends and neighbors, our fellow shining stars, who also celebrate Hanukkah and Kwanzaa, we hope that you have been enjoying your holidays as well too, and that you are winding down, that you are taking the time to really celebrate the small things in life. This final week of 2022, and that is very fitting. You know, Little Forrest, who is a newer arrival, obviously, here at PR from the Heart, he came into my life about a month or so ago. And, you know, many times as adults, we always want those amazing benchmarks to happen in our life, right? We want to be able to purchase the new house, acquire the first $1 million in our bank account, have our first child, and things in between. So there's those benchmarks. But one of the things that I always take the time to turn around and look at here in our offices here at PR from the Heart is a little quote, I believe, from The Wizard of Oz. And I'll turn around fully here. It shares, it's not the destination, but the journey that matters most. And leave it to a brand new children's book. They always help us see the way, correct? Leave it to a brand new children's book that is helping us to reconnect to God at this time of the year. That God is like a snowman, or building a snowman, or both. And to remember the importance of the simple things, because they really mean the most. We encourage all of you, again, our listeners and viewers, our friends and neighbors, and of course, our fellow shining stars, to head on over to Amazon.com. You can purchase your copy of God's Snowman. That is the newest children's book that is released by one of our favorite neighbors here at PR from the Heart and the Children's Book Spotlight Series. She is a former guest on the program. She is a best-selling author and illustrator, and she is the illustrator of God's Snowman that her sister Megan has actually birthed and created into this world. And she's been very essential in Little Forrest's growth and development in such a relatively short period of time as well. So joining us as our featured guest here on episode number 166 of the Children's Book Spotlight Series to close out our 2022 here at PR from the Heart is best-selling children's author and illustrator Rebecca Yee-Peters. So the trolley travels from San Diego, California, over to the panhandle of Florida in Pensacola, Florida. Happy holidays and Merry Christmas to you, Rebecca, and to your family. Thank you for spending some time to join myself and Little Forrest here today.
Oh, no problem. Merry Christmas.
Thank you so much. I absolutely love the book that you and your sister are creating. It's so interesting because, you know, a lot of times when we want to create something, we can get very much in our heads. Like, what's going to be the best children's book, or what do children need to hear, or what will sell, you know, a bazillion copies, right? But this is something that's very near and dear to your heart. All of your projects are obviously the Adventures of Pookie series. Everything that you do really is a reflection of the peace and the harmony that's in your life, and it's really, You're doing such an essential job right now. Very, very important work to be sharing this message with not only children, but also us as big kids as well, too. For those of our listeners and viewers, our friends and neighbors, and of course, our fellow shining stars who are learning about your work for the first point in time, let's take it back to the Wayback Machine to get a little bit of a refresher for those who actually may be familiar with your work. When did you specifically know? Was it a specific point in time that you knew that a large part of your work and your mission was here for the children? Was it a specific event, series of events? In essence, this kind of then shares how God's Snowman, in essence, came to be.
Well, taking it back, I started writing and illustrating in 2013. I was getting ready to celebrate my 30th birthday, and I was freaking out because I felt like I hadn't done anything with my life. So I just started writing. I have 13 nieces and nephews. I have one great niece and a great nephew on the way. So they pretty much inspired me to do everything that I've done. I have over 20 books at this point. And most of them I wrote and illustrated. My sister Megan has written a lot of them with me. She's such a great writer, so we collaborate really well. But it was only about 3 or 4 years ago that I wanted to fully put myself into this business and create all kinds of things for kids, not only the books, but learning materials and animations and things like that. So this is just a huge passion of mine.
And I love that you're communicating that, because it's, we all have toolboxes, right? And I think it's very easy, maybe kind of back in the day, we wanted to pigeonhole ourselves as one thing, author, right? Just one specific title. And it's so important so that we can be of the highest and best service to other people to really tap into many tools in our toolbox. So the fact that you're an author, you're an illustrator, you're an animator as well. By the way, the little cute animated introduction that you always see on the Children's Book Spotlight series and our Neighborly Reviews bookcast with David Newell from Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, of course, that is courtesy of one Rebecca Yee-Peters. Specifically talking about God's snowmen, you know, I take a look here on the during the Christmas season here, right outside of our offices at PR From the Heart, and I don't see snow outside, right? Now, obviously, bear in mind, I did spend the large majority of my life in Buffalo, so I do know what snow looks like. But this story is, it's such a simple story, and it's so precious on so many levels, but it's so strong, and it's so reaffirming. Could you share with us specifically you obviously shared the origin story of how things came to be for yourself and coming into the kid-led community. When was the origin of God's snowman? When did you and your sister know that this particular message needed to be shared, especially right now at the beginning of this Christmas season?
Well, several months ago, probably over the summer, my sister and I started brainstorming ideas of how we can bring the message of Christ back into different things, into books and our TV shows and things like that. And we found a meme of it was a pumpkin. It was about a pumpkin. And we actually our first one is called God's Little Pumpkin. We haven't gotten that one out yet. We got a little behind on the timeline with that one. So we thought, what else could we do like that? So God's Snowman came along. We're like, winter's coming up. We could do this really, you know? And so it kind of just snowballed from there, pun intended. and it's such, I have the book here, but it started because my sisters and I grew up in the church, and we went every Sunday. We'd go Sunday nights and go for youth group and things like that. And our parents were very involved in Bible schools over the summer. And so we were always there working. And we just saw the love and the hope that people gave when talking about God and when talking about Christ. And so we wanted to share that with our nieces and nephews. And my sister has two kids as well. And the youngest one is 6. So we're like, well, what can we do to help show her the love of God that also older kids and adults can also understand? And so the snowman was just kind of born because we grew up in Ohio and lots of snow. Florida, there's no snow out my window right now either. So the snowman book just kind of came because we wanted to show something simple that kids can relate to, that would be able to provide steps that could show them what God's love is like.
I love that too, because, you know, whenever I can remember many experiences that I had with snow on my end of things, and I know that my friends and family, neighbors out in Buffalo, they've been recently navigating through more snow on their end of things. And of course, not that long ago, there was the, I think, 6 feet of snow, depending upon where you lived in Buffalo. It was a really, really big storm that they had. It was a little over a month, probably close to 6 weeks or so ago by now. But it's very easy when you see snow and there's a lot of it, and you can get frustrated. And it can even create a lot of fear, like, oh my gosh, okay, you know, am I going to make it to work? Is my car going to slide off the road? Are my loved ones going to have enough food? Are they going to lose power? When will the snow melt? I mean, there's a billion different questions that you can have. But what God's snowman, at least from when I was reading it and intuiting it, it's really a message of enjoying this, not even just enjoying the winter season, but just enjoying whatever's happening right now. That even if you're finding life to be challenging, or you're in the midst of some sort of storm, to really take the time and slow things down and to appreciate those small things. I also really love as well too how, you know, the little one in the story, it's really, he's not just creating the snowman, but he's really creating a greater connection with God as he's doing that. So it's really, again, like a simple story, but it's multi-layered in the process. Again, we want to thank all of you for spending some quality time with us here in our neighborhood here this Christmas season at PR From the Heart. You are enjoying episode number 166 of the Children's Book Spotlight series with myself, John Masalonis. Of course, Little Forest is here with us as well, too, as we are interviewing best-selling children's author and illustrator Rebecca Yee-Peters. We are momentarily ready to dive into the pages of hers and her sister's brand-new children's book, God's Snowman. We encourage all of you to head on over to Amazon.com. That is your preferred online vehicle of your choosing. You can purchase your copy if you feel guided to do so, and leave a 5-star review, one of the many ways you can pledge your support for Rebecca and her sister Megan, to let the both of them know that they're doing wonderful and much needed work for children, parents, families, educators, those who love great children's books, those who love playing in the snow, those who love making snowmen as well too. Before we dive into the pages of God's Snowman, each and every year, one of my favorite Christmas classics that I watch is Frosty the Snowman. Of course, you know, and those, again, for like children that are, you know, this is like this generation of children, if you put in something from the 1960s, they're the heart is still there, but they might say like, wow, this kind of looks a little cheesy. But I always have to mention this too, because on the thread of snowmen, there was a special called Frosty Returns, which came out, I believe, in the early 90s, where John Goodman, of all people, played the voice of Frosty. And I think the late comedian Jonathan Winters was actually in it as well, too. The late Jan Hooks from Saturday Night Live. Again, I'm just very big on, like, on, you know, on holiday and Christmas specials that not many people actually are aware of. So when I was reading God's Snowman, I'm like, you know what? I think I need to watch Frosty the Snowman again. And when we think of, you know, building snowman again, that's one of those instantaneous memories that we have, whether it be building a snowman in our front yard, our backyard, watching Frosty the Snowman. When you and your sister made the decision to be able to create this book and bring God's Snowman into the life, how important was it for you to be able to create really a feel-good story so that, in essence, you know, it can be a deeper dive as well too, but people can have that cognitive and emotional connection of their favorite winter memories, their favorite Christmas memories, like Frosty the Snowman, like Frosty Returns, like making the snowman. How important was it for you to be able to create this as a feel-good story?
Well, Frosty was one of my favorites growing up as well. And to, when I first sat down to illustrate this book, I practiced snowmen for weeks, because drawing from images and things like that is easier for me. So I wanted to create something truly special in this. And, you know, it's just, I don't know. We wanted to show how simple the snowman can be, but something that, you know, everybody knows what a snowman is. Mm-hmm. Whether you have snow in or not, you know what a snowman is. I know people down here in Pensacola will build snowmen on the beach in the sand. So everybody knows what a snowman is. So we wanted to connect the simplicity of just snow in general with the larger message of hope and love in God.
I think that's very poignant that you're actually sharing that in the way in which you're sharing it as well too. It also goes back to also one of my other favorite Christmas specials, which is the Pee-wee's Playhouse Christmas special from 1988. Again, I recorded it from VHS, burned it onto DVD. So when I watch it every year, it's got the same 80s commercials, like Colgate toothpaste, Legos, isotoner gloves. But Pee-wee Herman always reminded us that if you don't have snow, you can also use 20 pounds of coconut shavings as he would always say. Then you can kind of create your own snow in the process. As we dive into the pages of God's Snowman, again, it's a very vibrant book as well, too. Whenever you illustrate your books, again, there's a lot of heart, there's a lot of intention, there's a lot of brightness. And I think it's really essential that we're communicating that message of brightness, even though the world in many respects for the past couple of years has felt kind of dark. And we've also been moving through our own darkness in different ways, shapes, and forms. For those who are learning about God's Snowman for the first time, of course, we don't like to give away the whole kit and caboodle here on the Children's Book Spotlight series. Could you really take us through the journey of the little one in the story and the connection that he has with the snowman and really these epiphanies that he has along the way when he's connecting with God and establishing this stronger relationship with him in the process?
Yeah, one of the main things we wanted to do was tell it from his perspective, because the perspective of children, they see things that us as adults cannot. So we wanted him to tell the story to kind of connect with us in a different way. As he goes through and builds the snowman, he thinks about all the things that he's learned from his mom. And his mom taught him, you know, God's love is eternal. So he crafts the snowballs, and because circles are eternal, you know, So he puts that connection there. And then with it being, we've always felt that being outside, you feel closer to God because God created the earth, and doing anything with the earth will make you feel more connected. So we wanted to kind of bring that in as well. So we put a bunch of trees and snow and like icicles and just little things that, you know, you wouldn't really think about being there. Mm-hmm. But you can tell that will connect everything in the end that God created. And, you know, he just goes through and thinks of all these little things, like a scarf. It keeps you warm, like God's love keeps you warm when you're down. And, you know, the arms are wide open so that God can give you a hug when you need it. And just little things like that that us as adults don't normally see. Like, we just think, oh, it's a snowman, you know, like we don't really pull connections together like children do. So that was kind of the main goal of the story.
And again, this is why the story is very simplistic, but it's also multifaceted. It has different layers to it. And again, you know, many adults can just be like very earthy. And when I say earthy, it's just like, it's a snowman and we're going to build a snowman. And there's nothing wrong with that. But to really find, not only to enjoy the simple things, but to find deeper meaning and deeper connection. So, you know, for example, it really is all about intention. So I know that when I was hanging up my Christmas tree and, you know, hanging up my lights as well too, you know, sometimes when we have the to-do list, it's a matter of, okay, I have to get up the Christmas tree. I have to get up the lights. But to be very intentional about, wow, like there's so much light that's around me. And that's a representation of the light that's within me and the connection that I have with God and that God is light. And again, you know, especially whenever you're moving through any sort of a challenging moment or a challenging day. I know the other day, little Forrest pooped in my bedroom for the first time. And there was the part of me that's like, okay, you know, I really need to remember my connection with God right now, because, you know, it was little first poop in my bedroom kind of thing, right? But even, again, just to take the time, slow down, you know, these things can happen, but it's just a matter of, again, how that you take the time to be able to respond as well, too. And also, again, so, you know, when I also really love the story, because when little ones now create their own snowman or even create anything, and this is the great thing about children's books is that little ones can intuit things in their own way. So whenever little ones are, you know, making a sandcastle, for example, right? There's a lot of sand, obviously, in Florida, a lot of sand out here in San Diego. But when little ones are making their own sandcastles, they can have their own way of connecting with God. Like, so for example, if you have a little drawbridge on the sandcastle, it's like, you know, my heart is opening and, you know, God's love is, we're opening to me, that kind of thing. So it really helps to create a conversation with little ones. And that's where the next thread that I wanted to get into within the story. You know, little ones have gone through quite a bit over the past several years between, you know, the pandemic and distance learning and being away from their friends. And, you know, thankfully now for the most part, you know, 2022 was the year where we all managed to do our part to kind of make up for lost time while also get back on the right track. In the work that you're doing, between, you know, writing books and illustrating books and your animation projects, in many respects, you're creating connections and conversations with children, with their parents, with their families. Why is that so important to you in the work that you do?
Well, I think that as we get older, we kind of fall away from connecting like we used to when we were kids. So to bridge that gap, and I don't know about you, but I feel our generation has gotten so involved and so consumed by media, you know, television, movies, our cell phones, social media. So I think we've gotten so involved in that, we've forgotten to live in the moment or in the real world. So we want to bring that back to where kids and adults can connect together again. And that's why it's so important to me. And it's important to also bridge the gap between older generations and younger generations, because the younger generations are learning from us. So if we don't teach them good values and how to be good people and how to take care of the earth and how to, you know, take care of themselves, then they're not going to learn it. So that's another thing that's important to me with all these nieces and nephews that I have, is I want to also help teach them, you know, and kind of guide them through their life.
It's wonderfully shared. It really is. Don't you agree, Little Forest? We're beginning to wind down our time with our featured guest here on episode number 166 of the Children's Book Spotlight Series, best-selling children's author, illustrator, and animator, Rebecca Yee-Peters. We are fully in the midst of enjoying her brand new children's book, hers and her sister's new children's book, entitled God's Snowman. You can head on over to Amazon.com if that is your preferred online vehicle of your choosing, and you can leave a 5-star review for God's Snowman. That's one of the many ways you can pledge your support for children, parents, pledge your support for Rebecca, to let her know that her and her sister are doing wonderful and much needed work for children, parents, families, educators, those who love great books, and of course, those who love to build snowmen in the process as well too. We always like here at the Children's Book Spotlight Series to provide some essential information, some supportive information, especially for moms, dads, grandmas, grandpas, caregivers of little ones, educators, especially as we're doing our part to, you know, slow down over the course of these final days of 2022 and really prepare for 2023. There really is a lot of preparation that's happening right now. I feel that it's going to be a great year for all of us in the process as well too. So two specific things actually come to mind in terms of going back to the core message, the theme of episode number 166 of the Children's Book Spotlight Series, and it's taking the time to enjoy the small things in life. There's times where we really need to go back to the basics, right? Where, you know, we'll be so in our heads and trying to figure things out, right? And that's when we can tend to create some challenges for ourselves. But for those who are struggling during the holidays, because the holiday season can be a time where, you know, people experience, you know, greater trauma, or even just like a refreshing of that older stuff. You know, whether it be someone has recently lost a loved one, or maybe this is the first Christmas that they're on their own after a recent breakup on their end of things. Could you share with us really the value and why taking the time to be with the small things and enjoy the small things, really why that is essential, maybe now more than ever before, especially as we're doing our part to be able to prepare for the forthcoming year ahead?
I think connecting with the little things in your life, or the things that make you happy in your life, are going to help you in the long run, because stressing yourself out over large things happens all the time. I mean, you know, your car breaks down, or, you know, you have a leak in the roof, or things like that. Just stress you out. But if you connect with the little things, you can see how much you truly have to be, that you're blessed with. And that's the whole goal of this, is to connect with the little things, see what you have, and know you're blessed.
That's true. And I think that that's a very timely reminder that many, many of our listeners and viewers, our friends and neighbors and our fellow shining stars can very much hold on to and move with as well too. The holidays are a time of the year where we really do our part to reconnect to God. You know, many people are all about setting New Year's resolutions. I use the term New Year's intentions because, you know, intention, it's not, you know, a resolution is something you can just kind of wiggle your way out of, so to speak. You know, after, you know, I'm going to do my part to lose 10 pounds and go to the gym, you know, more often in January. Then by the third week in January, it's like, man, I don't know about that at all. Yeah. But where it's an intention, it's something that it there really, it's more of a greater chance of sticking, so to speak. But the holiday season leading into the start of the new year, it's all about creating a clean slate. It's all about taking the time to start anew as well too. And this is really where reconnection to one's faith comes in. One of the things that I love at Unity Church, which I belong to out here in San Diego, there's Unity churches across the country. They have two specific ceremonies, one which is a burning bowl, in which in essence, if there's something that you want to release and let go of, right, you write it down, and then they have like a little, you know, contained fire, and you can just throw that in. And then they have a white stone ceremony the following week, which is where you write your word for the year. So it's very like my word for 2023 is harmony. And so it's a matter of really creating more and more intention. So really the importance of connecting to one's faith. Now, some people may be so in the midst of something without judgment. They may be in the midst of something or some things, and they may say, Rebecca, John, Little Forest, where do I begin? What do I do? And obviously this kind of depends upon what one's beliefs are, you know, if one is Catholic or Jewish, but just to kind of simplify things, if one is looking to be able to reconnect to their faith, to be reintroduced to God, what are some specific ways, whether it be someone who is, to a certain extent, lost themselves in the process, what are some supportive ways that one can reconnect to their faith? And then simultaneously, what are some ways that we as parents and caregivers can help our little ones to be more, to introduce them to God and to be able to help them connect stronger with their faith? Taking the first part of that question first.
Well, one thing I definitely suggest is just going outside. Whether you just sit on the ground and breathe and look around you, or just go for a walk, or, you know, get some time outside, because not only is the vitamin D going to help raise your mood, you're going to see things around you. Nature just automatically brings a smile to your face because there's so much around you and things you don't normally, you know, the flowers or the bushes or, you know, the trees, things that people don't appreciate that are there for us. So just go outside and breathe is one of the main things I would tell people. Another thing is to volunteer at places. You know, animal shelters need help, or homeless shelters, or soup kitchens, things like that. And that's a good way that you can get your young ones involved too, is take them to a dog shelter. You know, go out and walk the dogs or play with them, or take some food to the dog shelter, or, you know, go to the soup kitchen and serve some meals. There's little things that you can do to not only start your process in your faith again, but just reconnect with people and life in general again.
I think that those are very supportive tips as well too. And again, we don't necessarily need to overcomplicate things. If there is, you know, a pull that you have, you know, for some people, it's more about being of service to children. For some people, it's more about giving back to the homeless. For some people, it's more about helping domestic violence survivors, sexual abuse survivors as well too. However you feel guided, there really is no specific, here's the answer. It's just whatever you feel is the calling in your heart. And just know the fact that it's, I also go back to one of my favorite Christmas classics. I always quote Francis Xavier Cross, of course, which is the character in the beloved Bill Murray Christmas classic Scrooged. And he, you know, it's of course the story of Ebenezer Scrooge. And he, you know, as Francis Xavier Cross, he says, it's not too late. I didn't miss it. And that feeling that you have, being able to be, being able to to connect with your faith, or reconnect with your faith, to be able to reconnect with God, to reconnect with yourself. Because when you're doing your part to reconnect with yourself, you're also reconnecting with God as well, yeah. too, that it's really that mirror effect, so to speak. So for example, you know, when I take a look at Little Forest each and every morning, when I wake up, this is a reminder of like, this is a reflection of the love that's within my heart. It's a reflection of the love that God has for me. It's just in a little ball of fur kind of thing, which is absolutely fantastic. The work that you're doing as well is continuing into 2023 and beyond. And you've been working on a very big project that is finally launching in 2023. And of course, we've got all the different streaming servers, right? You know, between streaming services, I should say, between Disney Plus and Hulu and Netflix. The great thing is that there is such a demand for this content. I see, like when people use the term content, I think that's a very canned term, right? Because like you can just create content for the sake of creating content, but you're really creating heartfelt content, much needed content as well too. Could you, for those who are unfamiliar with your work as an animator, could you help to kind of peel the veil back on what you really have in store that's launching in 2023?
Sure. Last year, my company was approached to be a featured creator on a streaming service for kids. And the goal is to launch early 2023. So we have several TV shows and animations and things like that that are going to be on this app. And we're really excited about all the stuff we have happening. Well, one of the animations that your fans and your followers can see right now, if they want to watch my animation Mission Fat Hearts, I will give you a promo code that you can have your followers watch. So I would love for them to see the Mission Fat Hearts movie, even if it's after Christmas. It's a movie about love and kindness. But so we have TV shows coming up. We have different animation shows coming up. So all of that's going to be launching in 2023, and we're really excited about that.
That sounds fantastic. And I think, you know, we in our recent interview with award-winning and best-selling children's author and illustrator, the executive producer of Apple TV's Doug Unplugged, Dan Yaccarino, we were talking about how this is really the next step for many children's books. You know, before, and it was just a matter of like, okay, you know, you have an idea and you want to write a children's book and then you go out and promote the book. Right. But now it's kind of like that next step. Like, what if you want a children's book to really come to life even more? So, you know, a lot of the times when I was seeing, you know, all these streaming services like Hulu and Netflix, and there are these multi-billion dollar companies. And it's like, really, like, how much crap do you honestly need? But then it's like, all right, you know, I'm looking at the highest perspective and the fact that they're providing a lot of great content for children. But that's important, but it's still important to also spend the time, go outside, make the snowman, you know, go for walks, go to the beach as well too, because that can be a slippery slope for kids to, you know, spend so much in front of their screens and their devices that they lose out on the rest of life, so to speak. Your message, because again, you know, we're always doing our part as we, you know, turn the calendar from you know, at the end of the year to the beginning of the next year, 2022 to 2023. What is your message for the children that are out there? Because again, you know, 2022, as we mentioned, was a better year. You know, kids were, it was, you know, we were beginning to create this post-pandemic world, and now it's kind of like we're stepping into a higher, better normal. We've said for a long period of time that we want to create the best world for our kids possible. And now as the result of maybe losing out on some of that time to a certain extent and really seeing how precious truly life is, we're really realizing we as parents and caregivers that we can do more. And it starts with being the best version of ourselves so we can be the best version for the children in our lives. What is the message that you want to be able to share with children as we help them to prepare for 2023?
Well, I think the simplest message is be kind. Be kind to others. Be kind to yourself. That everything starts with kindness and everything starts with love. So just learn to love yourself. Learn to love other people and you'll have a great life.
That's a very simple message, but a very powerful message as well, too, which is a clear representation of all the goodness that you will find within God's snowman. Again, we encourage all of you, our listeners and viewers, our friends and neighbors, and of course, our fellow shining stars, to head on over to Amazon.com, purchase your copy of God's Snowman, leave a 5-star review. We have also included Rebecca's official website and social media platforms below so that you can continue this conversation post children's book spotlight series, as we like to say. I would be remiss, of course, you know that I'm a big Mr. Rogers guy here on Mind of Things, and it's been a sad past couple of weeks for the city of Pittsburgh because the beloved NFL Hall of Fame running back for the Pittsburgh Steelers, Franco Harris, recently passed away. And actually, the beloved floor director of Mr. Rogers' neighborhood, Nick Tallow, actually passed away a couple of days ago. If you, for everyone who watched the Mr. Rogers documentary, Won't You Be My Neighbor, he brought a lot of the humor into that documentary created by Morgan Neville. But of course, you know, we are always reminded of Mr. Rogers. And of course, his role on Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, and when he spoke all across the country at college commencement speeches, different talks, of course, episodes of The Neighborhood, but most notably so during his lifetime, when he received his Lifetime Achievement Award at the Daytime Emmy shortly before he passed from stomach cancer. And he always kept the time when he shared this, Rebecca. He always encouraged us to remember those who helped love us into being. And that was his way of saying, remember those people that came across our path who helped us to reconnect to ourselves, to realize that God does love us no matter whatever challenge that we're experiencing, no matter what we may have done or didn't do to this particular point in time, so to speak. Who would be some of the people that you would like to publicly recognize on episode number 166 of the Children's Book Spotlight Series that helped love you, Rebecca Yee-Peters, into being?
Well, my parents, for sure. My dad and my mom did a great job raising us. They are separated now, but we have my stepmom and my stepdad are both amazing people, and they all love us so much and provide the best for us. So I want to publicly thank them for sure.
That's awesome. And also your furry friends as well, too. I would be remiss if I did not mention You're probably one of the best people that I know that loves dogs the most. Like everyone loves dogs, but I think it's important that we share them as well too. Especially the connection that you had with your late dog Pookie.
Yeah, Pookie was the best dog. Thor and Bailey are both amazing. They're actually keeping me company this Christmas. My husband works on power lines, and he went up to the Northeast to work on the snowstorm. So Thor and Bailey are my family and my company for this Christmas, and they're the greatest.
They are, and a special shout out to
my husband.
Yes,
I was just for my husband for working so hard.
a special shout out to all of the linemen who are doing their part, whether it be during hurricanes, during tornadoes, during snowstorms, because of course they're doing our part to be able to keep us safe during the course of not only this Christmas season, during the winter, leading into 2023 and beyond. Of course, we always go back, especially during at this time of year, we always remember that we have the abilities. Like this is the time where wishes come true. I know it may sound very Disney cliche, right? You know, your wish can come true. It's Christmas time, right? But, you know, you hear the Christmas miracle, and I really feel that there's many people, and this goes, again, back to Francis Xavier Cross and Scrooge. There are people that are having difficulties receiving their Christmas miracle. And I think it's important for us here on the Children's Book Spotlight Series for our final episode of 2022 to be able to remember, because we're all given the gift of helping others to be able to reconnect to the love within them, to be able to remember that their dreams, their desires, their goals, their ambitions, that even if one is, you know, is 50 years old, that it's not too late, that everything always happens in perfect and divine timing. So it's a little tip of the cap to one of our favorite Disney animated classics. We remember the late Robin Williams. We remember as he voiced the genie of the lamp in the 1992 Disney animated classic, Aladdin. And of course, we always begin to conclude each Children's Book Spotlight Series episode with a little segment that we like to call Three Wishes. So with these wishes, obviously anytime who is a multiple time guest on the Children's Book Spotlight Series, we always send these wishes out to those in need. So we're being given three wishes. I'm giving three wishes to yourself, Rebecca, and they are for everyone in the world. Now, they can be for the children, they can be for the homeless, specifically, if you're being given these three wishes, how would you like to distribute those for the world this Christmas season and during the start of the new year?
Well, I guess the first one would be, that goes along with this whole message, is love. I wish love for everyone. You know, love yourself, love your neighbors, love your family. And love is really the glue that holds us all together. And then I wish peace and happiness for everybody. That's just who I am. I really love peace and happiness. It's the whole hippie thing. But yeah, those are the three things I would wish for the world.
And again, you're absolutely correct, because I feel that when one's wishes come from one's heart and the intention is pure, there's a greater chance of them coming to fruition. I think that 2023 is the year where we don't need to overcomplicate things at all anymore, that we can just take the time and to, again, it sounds like a cliche expression, smell the roses. So for example, here in San Diego, there is one of the largest parks in the country is Balboa Park. It has a 100-year-old carousel, which actually was made in Buffalo, which is kind of interesting. You obviously know that I'm from Buffalo. So whenever I go to Balboa Park and I see the carousel, it's like something from Buffalo was created, or something in San Diego was created in Buffalo. And it's just amazing. But to take the time, we're encouraging all of you that however you're spending your Christmas, however you're spending the final days of 2022, however you're spending your New Year's Eve, your New Year's Day, into 2023, that you take the time for yourself, you take the time to enjoy the small things, to go for that beach walk, to be able to look at the ocean, to be able to enjoy a nice Sunday service if you feel guided to do so, to curl up and read a great children's book. There's many wonderful children's books that are set to come out in 2023 as well, too. There are so many healthy ways that you can go about reconnecting to yourself and reconnecting with your faith. And just remember, all it takes is that commitment that you're making to yourself, because if you're struggling, whether it be with gambling or through alcoholism or through smoking or through any form of addiction, just know the fact that it is possible in 2023, if you really desire it in the process, that you can have a greater life and create more harmony in the process. Now, of course, as we hear the trolley, little forces, we hear the trolley, we know that it is time to go. But of course, there are many more magical trolley stops to come in 2023. And it's so interesting. When I was doing some Christmas shopping, I found this giant silver bow. And I thought, this is a great prop. It's a very cost-effective prop, Rebecca. But it's we're putting the bow on the children's book spotlight series for 2022. But before we share our final thanks and wrap things up here on episode number 166 of the Children's Book Spotlight Series, once again, stay connected with Rebecca via her official website. We've also included the link to her previous trolley stop on the Children's Book Spotlight Series, where I believe we share your wonderful children's book, The Hope Monster, in the process. So if you're looking for a message to be able to reconnect to more hope during the Christmas season, the New Year's holiday as well, leading into 2023. We've included that in the description below as well, too. And while on Amazon.com, you can take the time to purchase and enjoy any of Rebecca's other wonderfully authored and illustrated children's books as well, too. You can leave 5-star reviews for God's Snowman or any of Rebecca's books that you feel guided to do so. That's, again, one of the many ways you can pledge your support for her, to let her know that she's doing wonderful and much needed work for children, parents, families, educators, and those who love great children's books. And it's such a joy to be able to feature Rebecca's work here on the Children's Book Spotlight Series, because we've had some of the top illustrators in the world of children's literature on the Children's Book Spotlight Series this year. Our dear friends, John Parra, Matthew Cordell, Rafael Lopez. Of course, he illustrated the brand new book, The Little Book of Joy, which is, of course, co-authored by the Dalai Lama and Archbishop Desmond Tutu. So again, big shout out to all of the illustrators that are out there, because if it wasn't for illustrators, it would just be words on a page. And yep, it's not to say that wouldn't necessarily be fun, but you know, there's something about the books actually coming to life in the process. So of course, as I mentioned, there are many more magical trolley stops to come. If you are a children's author or a children's illustrator and would love to be able to share your inspiring story in the release of your brand new children's book and a forthcoming edition of the Children's Book Spotlight Series in 2023, you can connect with us via our official website, prfromtheheart.com, or connect with us via any of our social media platforms that you now see on screen. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all at PR From The Heart. of course, as well, too. We are going to be celebrating two wonderful times of the year in 2023. It's hard to believe we're going to be celebrating the two-year anniversary of the Neighborly Reviews Bookcast. That is, of course, the official children's book review program here at PR From the Heart, where myself and our dear friend and neighbor, David New, who played the beloved Mr. McFeely, Speedy Delivery, on Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. We, of course, just a little tip of the cap to his character, Mr. McFeely, on Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. We deliver the newest heartfelt reviews from the newest heartfelt children's books, shining stars in the kidlit community here at PR From the Heart. So between the two-year anniversary of the Neighborly Reviews Bookcast and, of course, the trolley, will be heading back to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Shout out to all of our supporters, all of our friends and neighbors out in Pittsburgh. We know that it's been a very rough past couple of weeks with the passing of the late NFL Hall of Fame running back from the Pittsburgh Steelers, Franco Harris, and, of course, the beloved floor director from Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, Nick Tallow. We will be returning to the Center for Media Innovation in downtown Pittsburgh at Point Park University to report our April and May editions of the Neighborly Reviews Bookcast. So if you are a children's author and would love to have your brand new children's book be shared and reviewed on a forthcoming edition of the Neighborly Reviews Bookcast in 2023, you know where to connect with us via our official website, prfromtheheart.com, or any of our social media platforms as well. And of course, we're looking forward to being of service to many of you, self-published and published children's authors in the kidlit community. If you are looking to be able to make more of a mark for yourself, to be able to create greater awareness and visibility for your message, but even more importantly, to make more of a difference in the lives of children, parents, families, educators, those who love great children's books across the country and around the world. If you are looking to facilitate a book media tour in a city of your choosing, if you're looking to facilitate one or several featured television interviews, or if you're looking to be able to explore more ways in which how we can be of service to you at PR From the Heart, you can head on over to our official website, which again is prfromtheheart.com. Schedule your courtesy connection call and let us see how we can be of service to you. Again, once again, one final time, great way to close out 2022. God's Snowman, it is now available. You can head on over to amazon.com. Leave your 5-star review. As we always like to say on the Children's Book Spotlight Series, only if it is in resonance with Little Force, because he is very picky choosy at the children's books that he gives 2 paws up to. But Little Force gives 2 big paws up for God's Snowman as well, too. You know, back in the day, like if you're a big movie buff, you remember Siskel and Ebert, and they gave it 2 thumbs up. Well, in our own way, you know, Little Force giving 2 paws up. That's incredible in and of itself. So, as we close out episode number 166 of the Children's Book Spotlight Series, one final tip of the cap to our favorite neighbor, the beloved Mr. Rogers. He encouraged all of us also in many different ways, shapes, and forms based on 3 numbers in his own private numerology. Mr. Rogers' favorite numbers were 1, 4, 3. I always like to say that I think that he must have met Ponce de Leon in a past life, because he managed to stay 143 pounds for his entire natural adult life, for the most part. There's 1 letter in I, 4 letters in love, and 3 letters in you. And that was Mr. Rogers' way of saying that you're loved and you're special just the way that you are, that I like you and I love you just the way that you are. So as Rebecca was very kind enough to join us, as well as Little Forrest, to close out the year here on the Children's Book Spotlight Series, episode number 166, we share our favorite numbers, which are 2, 4, 3. That is, of course, 2 letters in we, 4 letters in love, 3 letters in you. That is our reminder that you are loved, that you are special just the way that you are, that we like you, that we love you just the way that you are perfect, whole, healthy, and complete just the way that you are. Just like the snowman that you are creating this Christmas season, this winter season in the process. Also, special shout out to our team behind the scenes. Without them, there would be no us. So to Ling, to Venus, to Melissa. Again, we have a wonderful team that helps to bring the Children's Book Spotlight Series and the Neighborly Reviews Bookcast, all of the wonderful things that you see on our social media platforms and through our official website. We are going to be celebrating, hard to believe, our 9-year anniversary of being of service to children's authors and children all across the country and all around the world. So that's something that we're also looking forward to in 2023. So this is the final trolley stop of the Children's Book Spotlight Series, but we do hope that you enjoy episode number 22 of the Neighborly Reviews Bookcast, as indeed that is now available, where David and I dive into the pages and we review Adam Swain Ferguson's Love Without Wings, an adoption fairy tale, in addition to Gina Giordano's yet. So you've got another way where you can stay connected with us during the final days of 2022 and into 2023. But again, there are many more magical trolley stops to come. So we want to thank you for your continued support of PR from the Heart in 2022. I think we always like to hear that should old acquaintance be forgot. So if you're hearing a little auld lang syne in the background, we're definitely getting in the mood for New Year's, because this is going to be your first new year that you're officially coming into, Little Forest. So we want to thank you for your continued support of PR from the Heart, for your continued support of the Children's Book Spotlight series, as we're now in the fifth year of this program, and we're very grateful for it, for your continued support of children's authors and illustrators such as Rebecca, who again are doing wonderful and much needed work for children, parents, families, educators, and those who love great children's books, for your continued support of local libraries, children's and independent bookstores, truly the pillars of our community. And above all else, we want to thank you for helping us to walk home the children of the world. So for Rebecca Yee-Peters, for Little Forest, and for myself, John Masalonis, we hope that you enjoy the rest of your holiday season. Be sure to ring in 2023 safely, however you are spending it. And we hope that you have a happy, healthy, joyous, and prosperous 2023 from all of us here at PR from the Heart. Once again, thank you for helping us to walk home the children of the world, our fellow friends, our fellow neighbors, and our fellow shining stars. Goodbye for now. I want to say bye-bye, Little Forest. I want to say Happy New Year. Yay!
Happy New Year.